Hey guys, what's up? So this is continuations of hybrid framework, and we will see some more examples, and we will see that what is a systematic way where we can use the classes to insert the data to the database, and how a relationship between the class and DB will happen, right? And in fact, we'll see that the last class exceptions which we were getting, that when whenever we were trying to insert the data, it was saying that the name is already being used, right? The SQL exceptions. So everything we will see in this video. So what was happening in the last class? The problem what we had in the last class is, if you try to recollect the informations from the last class, in the saved data, right? We were trying to, sorry, in the stored data class, we were trying to store the data. So when we were trying to store the data, what was happening is we were getting exceptions and it was getting stored. In fact, I will show you the exception. So let's say this is my object, right? And let me do one thing. Let me try to insert the record, and we will get the same exceptions what we were getting in the last video. So it should throw the exception. Yeah, so this is the exceptions we were getting. Could not this one, unique constants violated. Okay, this is not the one. This is saying that unique constant violated, which I will talk later. Let me try to make a successful insertion to the DB. Yeah, so though it is successfully saved, we were getting that the name is already being used. The name is already being used by the existing object. So this was the problem, right? So the problem, why this problem was coming? Because if we will go to our this employee hbm.xml basically, right? So just try to see it here. Do not see the down one, which I will explain you the different class which I'm adding there. So if you look at here in the Hibernate mapping, basically it's a Hibernate mapping where we are mapping our classes, right? So when we say class is equal to this and table is name is equal to this, and when we say ID, the ID is equal to ID and generator class is equal to assigned, right? So when I say generator class is equal to assigned, which means we need to give the ID, and this will be considered as a primary key in our employee table, and this is the two properties we had in our employee class. Now whenever we try to insert the record, if we go to our hibernate.cfg, if you look at the first properties which we have, update, right? hbm2ddl.autoupdate. So what this guy will do, it will try to recreate the object, recreate the DB again, right? It will try to recreate the DB. So the DB name, the table name, so it will not try to recreate the DB, it will try to recreate the table. So our table name is employee table. Now this guy, because of this guy, it will try to recreate. Okay, it will try to recreate, and that is the reason we are always getting that, you know, it's already being used, because what this guy will do is it will drop your schema and it will try to recreate. Okay, so that is the reason we are getting that this is object is already being used by the existing object, right? So if you remove this line, if you remove the first line, hbm2ddl auto update, if you remove this, you know what happens is, now it will not try to recreate the table again. And if we will go to the, let's say, stored data, and let me do one thing, let me change to 29. And if I run this time, I should not get the exceptions, and I will explain you one more time. Okay, do not bother for that. See, it is saying that successfully saved, so the data got saved to the DB. So this 29, if you look at, if you refresh your MySQL, not this table, we had the table is equal to employee table, this is our table. So when we scroll down here, we can see that there should be something called ID should be 29. So we can see that here ID is equal to 29 and record is getting inserted. Now let me brief you again, so that you know you'll have clear understanding of how we can insert the data to the DB through Hibernate, right? Let me go from the beginning because you know I got a message saying that explain one more time. So I will go one more time. Let's say we have employee informations. This need to be stored into the database, right? So in case of Hibernate, what we need to do, first we need to create a POJO class. So the POJO class is nothing but the fields, the informations which you want to store in your employee table. So I want to store ID, first name, last name, and then create a getters and setters, right? So basically your class all the fields name will be considered as a column name in the DB. If you look at here, these are the all column name, ID, first name, last name, right? ID, first name, last name. So that will be the corresponding column name. Now if you insert 5 records, it will be the 5 rows to the employee table. So why I am saying that employee table, because this class, whatever class we have and the data, and when we are trying to insert the data to the DB, this class will act as in a persistent object, right? This will act as in the persistent object. The persistent object is nothing but the object which we are going to save into the database. Basically, it's nothing but records. Now, for this employee, what we have is we have employee hbm.xml, right? Employee hibernate.xml. Here, you try to focus from here, okay? These all annotations are very simple to write. You can, when you say angle bracket, you can see that, you know, comments, and in fact, you should get this information also, the Hibernate one. See here, you can write that angle bracket and Hibernate, automatically this syntax will come, right? You don't need to remember actually. You just need to remember Hibernate mapping, and then inside that map the class. For what class you want to map the data in the DB? So I want to map the class employee class, and this class has a corresponding table in the DB called employee table. Okay, this class has a corresponding table. So this table will get created on the runtime automatically first time. Second time onwards, it will use the same table. And then I'm saying that in that table, employee table, ID is a primary key. Okay, so this is the employee table where ID, I have a primary key, right? And employee table, it will get created automatically on the runtime. Now, and I have two more properties, first name and last name, right? You can define the type also. If it is a type, a string, you can write here type is equal to a string, right? So you can define the type also, and then you know your class will get closed. So till here is a one class. Now this is your mapping class where you are mapping your class with the DB table, right? Now this is Hibernate CFG. This is a configuration class. In the configurations class, again these things you can just write angle bracket, and when you say Hibernate config, right? So ideally this should come Hibernate hyphen control space bar. No, okay, no problem. So but ideally this angle bracket should come when we try to write that. Okay, Hibernate configurations, fine. Now right click, and when I say this is XML CTest style, okay, no problem, it is not coming. You can just type this, it's not a big thing which we cannot remember. Yes, of course we can remember. Let me delete the unwanted stuff from here. Yeah, so now we have something called Hibernate configurations. So this is like the configurations of your database. All the database, you can keep it here, as well as you can also specify the configurations where you have mapping between your table and your class. So when you say this inside the Hibernate configurations, we have another tag called session factory, right? So inside the session factory, we have a property name called dialect. So the dialect is basically, we are using Oracle 10g So we need to use the dialect so that you know it will communicate to the database. So dialect basically it will work as a interface between your Java and in your Hibernate. So for every DB there will be a dialect which I'll talk about in this video. And then this is the URL. Since DB I have in my local host, so I can just say thin at localhost and port, and then XC is the service. Then this is the username password, and the driver class is equal to JDBC driver dot Oracle DB, and this is our mapping class where I am mapping the class to the table, right? So employee.hbm.xml, employee.hbm.xml. Now I have created another method called save data. So just we need to remember 3 to 4 lines of code to work with the Hibernate. So first we need to create the object of configurations class, right? We are creating the object of configurations class, and we know that this is our configurations. This Hibernate configurations we need to actually populate, right? We need to take the data from this configurations. So whatever configurations object we have created, it has a method called config, and this guy will take this configurations. So once this configurations has been created, what we will do is we will create a session factory, right? So to create a session factory on the configurations, we have a method called build session factory. This will give us the session factory. So we got the session, right? And session factory is the immutable. So we got the sessions. Now from the sessions factory, what we'll do is we'll open the sessions, like session is opened. So we have the session, we got the session factory. Now we need to open the session. So session has been opened. Once the session has been opened, we'll start with the transactions, like what transactions we want to do. So we want to add the data, we want to insert the data, we want to delete the data, that we can do that on that session, right? So once we have a begin transactions, if you look at here I am trying to create the object of employee class. The employee class is nothing but the class, basically it's a POJO object, and which data need to be stored into the DB. And then we are setting all the setters. Once we set all the setters, what we do is session.persist, which means we save the data to the DB. Session.persist, when we say persist, is nothing but save. Inside that we supply the employee object, right? So when we supply the employee object, this data will get saved to the DB, and then we do a commit. Commit means it's a so when we do commit means whatever data we have in the DB, it will get committed, right? So first it will get saved, and then we do a commit, and then we close. So that's how this record will get saved, and that's how we can save the record to the DB. Now this is very you can say that first level of coding, where everything I'm writing in the main method and I'm trying to save. But actually what happens is when we use in the project, it should be in the systematic way. So how to do that? What we can do is, I have created one class called Hibernate Utils, right? So this class I have created just to get the session factory, just to get the session factory object. Okay, so if you look at in this Hibernate util, I have a variable called private static final session factory. So in this session factory, basically what happens is whenever from any class if I will call Hibernate utils, right, dot get session factory, right? So basically this is nothing but it's a kind of singleton, right? So here what I'm trying to do here is I have a private variable, right, and I have a static block. So in the static block, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to create the object of session factory. If you look at here, so I'm saying that session factory is equal to new configuration.config.build session factory, right? So this is our session factory, and we have a method called get session factory. So this get session factory return the session factory, and since it is a static block, so we know that whenever you call this class, first a static block will get executed automatically. Okay, because the static members will be loaded to the class when class is loaded to the memory, right? So when we call this method, before executing this method, this will be executed and the session object will get created. So we can get the session object. So that's how we should do. This is one way. I will show you another way also. So Now we have a hibernate util. From there, say we can get a session factory. Now, how to use this? Okay, I will show you with the example. So what I did here is, this is my hibernate utils, and what I did is I've created one EMP class. In this EMP class, I have four members: ID, first name, last name, and salary. Right, and I have two constructor here. One is default, one is parameterized. So in this class, in this POJO class, we have two constructor now. One is default, one is parameterized, and we have same getters and setters, nothing different. Right, so this is nothing but basically you can say that persistent object, and this object data we are going to store to the DB. So how to do that? So this is getters and setters. I don't think so you guys will get any doubt here. Now your persistent class object is ready. Now if you'll go to your employee sbm.xml, what I did here is I added one more class, right, which is nothing but package name dot class name hibernate.emp. And here if you look at, I have made id is equal to native, right? I have made id is equal to native, and three properties I have: first name, last name, and salary. This id is equal to native, this generator class I will talk after this. Okay, I will talk after this what does mean by this generator classes. First let me go through the code. So this guy, if you look at this, I have another class called minus EMP. So this EMP, we have another class called minus EMP. Here what I did is, the first method which will add the employee to the DB. That's how you should design actually. So this guy will add the employee to the DB. So when you are adding the employee, what are the informations you want, right? So if you will come here, your employee has ID, first name, last name, and salary. So when you are trying to add that, you need to add first name, last name, and salary. So I have a variable called, I have made one variable called session factory, right? So this variable has a type of session factory. So on the session factory, if you look at the save data, on the session factory I can directly call open session. So on the session factory I can call the method open session, and session will get started. Same thing I'm doing here. On this factory I'm calling open session, right? I'm just calling open session. So when session is started, in beginning I have transactions is equal to null, right? And then I will do that on that session, whatever session is opened now, I'll begin the transactions, right? So the transactions will get started. Whatever we did here, transactions will get started. Once the transactions will get started, I am creating the object of parameterized constructor of this EMP class, right? The POJO class. I am creating the object of this, right? So when I create the object of this, your all first name, last name, salary will get initialized. Your all POJO class will get instantiated, which means it will get initialized. So once this guy will get initialized, once this object is ready, I will do session.save. Okay, session.save I will do. So here I will do, I was doing that persist. So either you can do persist or you can do a save, right? So if you look at here, let me show you. If you do dot session dot, so we have, you have a persist which will take the object, and in fact I will tell you the difference also. Or you can do the save, serializable, right? So you can use any one. I will tell you the difference going forward. So I am doing that save. When I do a save, basically when we save this object to the DB, like we are going to save the object to the DB, so what happens is, when we save this, and if you look at your employee HBM here, this is called native. So what happens, for every record, one unique ID will get generated in the DB, and that will be treated as a primary key of the DB. So unique ID will get generated, right, automatically, and that will be treated as a primary key of the DB. So whatever we will save, when we save, basically after saving that, I am casting this to the integer, right? So when I will save that, what happens is we will get one integer ID, integer ID for this record, and this is nothing but your employee ID, right? So here if you look at, I have made employee ID is equal to integer, which I will show you during run also. And then I do transactions dot commit. So that's how you can add the employee. So whenever you will call this method, this guy will add the employee. Similarly, list the employee, like this method will add the record and this will list. List means it will get the record. So when I say list employees, so again the factory we have, on this factory I will call the method called open session. So session will get started. In beginning transactions equal to null, again I will begin the transaction. So once I will begin the transactions, on this sessions I will call the method called create query. So sessions dot create query, and create query you just need to say from which table you want the data. So I want the data from the EMP table, so just you need to write from EMP. This is very simple. I want it is very simple. And then do dot list, so I want the data in the form of list. I want all the data. So like how we write in the SQL, select star from EMP, right? Same thing will happen here. All the data will come. And if you look at here, here I have made in angle bracket, I'm giving a questions because I'm making it generic. So whatever type will come, it will get accepted. So I'm writing a question here, question mark, which means I'm making the list as a generic. Now once I get the list of data, right, what I'm doing here is, if you look at here, right, I am basically using here, I'm using this concept. If you look at, this is nothing but your for each loop, where what I'm trying to do is I'm iterating over the data. I am iterating over the data. So either you can do like this, or okay, for your better understanding I will not write like this, maybe you will get confused. So I'll write here, and what I will do here is we'll delete this iterator. So one second, or what I will do better is, dot has next. Okay, or I will not use the for, I will use the while. Okay, so same thing here, I am running a loop over the iterator, right? And if iterator has a more element, what I will do, I will get iterator dot next. So what happens when we get the object, it will not be of type EMP, right? It will not be of type EMP, so I'm casting to the EMP. So whatever object will come, the session object, we need to cast to the class, like which class type you want. So I'm casting back to the EMP, because the data when we inserted it was of EMP type object. So we are casting back, and then since we are casting and the reference is called employee from that object, as we know that every object, we have the informations of first name, last name and salary, because when one row data will come from the DB, the one row data, you have the informations of first name, last name and column name. See, you have informations of ID, first name and last name from the DB when you say one record, right, which is nothing but one object. And then we do transactions dot commit, right? So this is for list all the data from the DB. Similarly, I have method called update employee. So if you look at here, update employee, when you say update employee, you need to supply the employee ID, which is nothing but your primary key in your DB. So you need to supply the employee ID, and I want to update the salary of the employee for the given employee, right? So same thing I will do here, factory.open session, transaction is equal to null, then we'll begin the transactions. And then this is very important, guys, okay, sessions. So whatever sessions I have, I will do a get. Okay, I will do a get. First I will try to get this employee ID from the DB. First I need to get in the session. So for that, what we need to do is we need to supply the object of the class. So we have to write emp.class, which is the instance of the class. So for which class I want to do that? I want to do for this class, right? So emp this class. So we'll get the instance of the class and we'll supply the employee ID. So for that ID, we will get the employee object. So once we get the employee object in the session, on that object reference, we'll do set salary is equal to salary, like whatever salary we have the method, and then we will do session, right? Basically everything is happening in the sessions object. So I will do session dot update, and when I say session dot object, I will give back the reference. So in this object, I am setting the salary of the employee, and then I'm saying that session dot update. So the data will get updated, and then I will do transactions dot commit. So that's how we do actually update data to the DB. So this employee ID is nothing but the ID of every employee. Okay. And then I have something called delete employee. This is the last method where I'm doing the delete employee. Here we need to supply the employee ID, which is a primary key. So again, I will do factory.open session, and then I will do transactions is equal to null, sessions.begin transactions. So once the transactions will start, again, I will do session.get. So we need to get that employee ID from the DB. So we need to supply the persistent object class. So I'm saying that emp.class is equal to employee ID. So we need to basically supply the object of the persistent class, and then I will say employee ID. So what happens? We will get that record which has this matching ID, and then I will do session.delete. So on that session object, I will delete this employee, and then I will do transactions.commit. So that's how the delete will work. Sometimes when the exceptions will come, it will go to the catch, and here we'll do a rollback. Rollback means it will roll back to the previous record, it will not get deleted. And if you look at everywhere, I'm writing a finally. So finally session should get closed. So if you look at all three methods, right, I'm writing a finally, so that, you know, I need to make sure that the session should be closed. No matter exception is coming, not coming, I want to close the session. So we have to write finally. Same thing here, if transaction says not is equal to null, rollback. So always rollback. If any exceptions come and transactions not is equal to null, always rollback. Okay. Always roll back. That's what we had to do. So this three method is ready. Now we need to test this three method. So what I did, we have basically, if you look at, we have a main method here, and this hibernate utils. So whatever utils we have, I'm calling the method called get session factory. So we'll have a session factory. So what I will do, hibernate dot get session factory, right? I'm writing in the try catch block. So when exceptions comes, I will say that exceptions, you know, initialize error, right? I will say that, like, there was exceptions in the initializations. And then what I'm trying to do here is I'm creating the object of this class so that I can call the method. So on this reference, okay, on this reference, if you look at, I am calling that add employee. So when I'm calling that add employee, so add employee method, which takes three arguments, fname, last name and salary. Same thing I'm doing here, first name, last name, salary, first name, last name, salary. I'm adding three records, and this every add employee method will give us the employee ID. It will give us the employee ID, which will get generated on the runtime. So for all three, we will get a employee ID, which will get generated, because if you look at here, your add employee is basically returning the employee ID, and which is coming from this. So whenever we are saving the object to the DB, we will get the corresponding employee ID. And then I'm calling list employee. This guy will list all the employee, and then I'm saying that update employee. So to do the update employee, what we need to do, as we know that update employee method, if you'll go here, if you look at the update employee, it requires the employee ID and it requires a salary. So I'm supplying the employee ID one, which we got while adding it. So while adding it, so for that first employee, I want to save the salary, and then I want to delete the employee. So I want to delete the employee of employee ID 2, which I want to delete. And again, I want to do employee of list employee, just to make sure that whether record got deleted or not. What I will do is I will just write here to understand whether the record is getting deleted or not. So I'm making a block so that we can understand. One second. So when we have this block, we can easily understand like what is happening on the runtime. Yeah. So now first I will run in the debug mode. So what I will do is, just to show you, I will do a right click, I will do run debug as Java applications. So when we debug as a Java applications, it will come here. I will click on yes. So the session object will get started, F6. I have already debug point here, so that is the reason it is starting from here. If you look at now, the session object got created, right? And the session has been already opened and it got created. Now go next, begin transactions, next. So what is the employee object? This is the employee object which has this method, which has this informations. The employee object has this informations, right? And then I will do session.save. So when we do session.save, now go back to your the Hibernate mapping. So employee HBM mapping. So this class is getting called, and here we have something called native. So ID will get generated automatically and it will get inserted to the DB. If you look at here we are not inserting the ID, though we have ID here, right? We are not inserting the ID, right? So ID will get inserted automatically. It will consider as a primary key to the DB. So if you go to the DB here, and this is our EMP table, I'll refresh this. So as of now, we have only till 90, right? Only till 90 we have, 19 we have. So when we go here, come back to the manage employee, and if I'll do F6, so what happens now? Data should get inserted. So there should be a 20 refresh. So still it is a 90. What I will do is, again I will go here, I think, yeah, commit. Now it is done, data got committed to the DB. So if you look at here, the 20 has come, right? So ID has come, 20 has come. We are not giving that, we have given why it is coming, because in this we have given generate class ID is equal to native, so automatically sequence will get followed and it will be a primary key. So now come back here. Now if you look at here, what is the ID? ID is equal to 20, right? So that's how the additions will happen. Similarly, all the methods will get called. So even you guys can put a debug point and you guys can try to understand. Now if I'll do run as Java applications, if I'll run the entire things in the one shot, you can see like this. So this is your informations which you are getting here, and then this is the informations which you are getting here. So what I will do, just to show you in the better way, wherever I am calling this, right, I will make one segment here and one segment here. Now we can see that all segment, like how additions is happening, then how listing will happen. Here the listing is happening, so it is trying to list all the informations from the DB. So now if I'll do run as Java applications, now look at the console output. So I am seeing some error here, invocations, target exceptions, okay, which I will fix that. Hibernate connection pool size is equal to 20, minimum is equal to 1. Okay, no problem, this I will fix that, okay. But this is your, I think, retrieval. This is your retrieval. So again, what I will do, just to show you retrieval, let me, instead of writing hyphen, let me write this, right? And here let me write that employee. This is good actually. And then here I will write update, and here I will write after the update we are deleting it. So here we are deleting that, yeah, cool. And then again we have list employee. So now everything is pretty clear now. And now I think we will get a very good sequence. Yeah, so let me run this now. So update delete, we didn't get any record. That is fine because we are not printing anything. When I say list employee, if you look at here down, list employee, we are getting all the informations. And this is your add employee. So in add employee, you will not get any informations because you are not printing anything. In the list employee, we can see that. But whatever we deleted, right, we should able to see that what got deleted. Here we are not able to figure out why, because let me do one thing, let me add something which we can understand, right? So let me add with my name so that I can see in the report what is happening. So okay, now what I will do is what I'm deleting, I'm deleting this record. So if you look at here, I'm updating the first one. So I'm dating the Bhanu one, right? And let's say I'm updating with 5. Okay, and then I'm deleting the employee 2. So I'm deleting the 500, this one. So what I will do, I'll keep here 50. So first time when we say list all elements, 50 should come. Second time after delete, 50 should not come. Now I think clearly we will understand. So if I'll do run a Java applications, look at the output now. So when we look at the output, the first time 50 has come, this is the one, right? Bhanu 1, Pratap 1, salary is equal to 50. In the second time, see, you have Bhanu Pratap 5 and 50 has deleted. So that's how the data got deleted from the DB, right? And that's how it is working, guys. So it's working fine without any issue. And this is very, very helpful, guys. So if you just go through 2-3 times through the video and the code, you'll easily understand how we are doing that. So I'll be continuing with some more videos of the Hibernate. I'll be showing that how to make a lot of other things. Here, if you look at, I'm using get method. There is something called load method, which we'll see in the next video, like what does mean by get and load. Okay. And we will see some other persistent object which has a relation with other objects. So let's say as of now, if you look at, we have employee where we have first name, last name, salary. So let's say employee has object called, I mean the this object has one more object called address object, and which has a lot of informations, right? So that, how do we handle that? We will see that going forward. So what only my suggestion is, please go through line by line of the code, write the code in your Eclipse, and whatever I'm trying to do, that you also try to do that, and then you'll be very good into the Hibernate, and this will add one skill set in your resume, and confidently you can say that I know the Hibernate also. Okay, thank you guys, thank you for watching this. Hope you like this video. So if you like this, hit like button and subscribe my YouTube channel.